bearded burbler. He's in his element.
It's just like nature. It's what we're all about.
Wagons ho! Have a look at that! Oh! Oh.
Just when they think it's safe to come out.
Not an animal!
Bang!
I guess in the end, that's probably why we all go fishing.
Mullet, is it?
Not your bait, is it?
Well, it can't. Mullet can't make a boil like that. Mullet can't make a boil like that, mate.
Might have one come up look at it.
Yeah, something's got it. Okay. Something's got it. Come out of that. Come out of that. Come out. Yes, he's out of those snags, Wazza. He grabbed that mullet like there was no tomorrow. I tell you what, and that is a very, very good lesson, folks. We are in the top end of Australia, one of my really favourite areas, and we're fishing for barramundi, and on this occasion, I haven't got a barramundi. I've got a beautiful mangrove jack. Now, this is as good as they come up here, although there are bigger fish caught, we know, off camera. But this is a perfect eating and a perfect size. Wazza, do your stuff.
Beautiful size mangrove jack for this.
How about that? Isn't that just magnificent? Now, folks, you might have recognised me when I said Wazza, because if you've fished up here, there's a real chance that you've fished with Wazza. If you walked into Darwin and said, I want a fishing guide called Warren Smith, they'd go to the phone book and say, no appearance. Everyone calls you Wazza. You love fishing. You love taking me fishing. It's great to have you on the show again.
It's great to be back with you again, Rex.
Isn't it fantastic? Okay, I'm going to really pick your brain. Before we pop this bloke back, I need you to tell our viewers all over the world just what a beautiful fish the mangrove jack is.
They are. They're one of the best eating fish that we'll get in the top end.
Yeah.
Members of the Lugenets.
Yeah.
Which is like the golden snapper.
Yeah.
And a few other fish. And That's a good sized mangrove jack,
isn't it?
Out of the estuary. They grow bigger when they go out in the ocean,
yeah,
live on
do.
The reefs,
yeah.
But in the estuary systems like this, when you're fishing, that's a good sized mangrove jack.
And was a real predator. He's got the eyes of a predator, just like a golden snapper or a barra, and some serious dental equipment down here.
Like most legends, so you wouldn't put your finger anywhere near that.
Absolutely magnificent. I'll give him a peck on top. And Wazza, you can do the honours over there. And just let me tell you folks what we're doing. We are fishing here to try and catch you some fish to show you down that camera lens. Things are tight on lures. We've always got a lure handy, and if we try a set of snags, what we do is if we don't get a bite, we put on a bit of bait like a mullet, and my goodness gracious me, you always come up trumps.
Barra.
didn't he? Grab it was.
As soon as that hit the water, he nailed it.
Aren't they just ready for the opportunity?
Not a monster, but he is a nice little barramundi.
Barramundi.
One of your favourite fish, aren't they, Rex?
Oh, they are. I think they are my favourite fish. And down south, the brown trout and the King George whiting and the snapper and the flathead. I just love fishing, you know. It's trying to inspire kids to do what they want to do, and all I wanted to do was just to do something in fishing as a kid, you know what I mean? And these fish here, you have seen them more than I have, although I've been coming up here since 1982, and that was before you, but you do this for a living, and you probably never tire of it, do you?
Never.
Yeah. What does barramundi mean to the legendary Wazza?
Well, they're a great fish because you can catch them on lure, bait, fly.
Yeah.
And they're very spectacular fish to catch.
Aren't they?
They're a great looking fish.
Yeah, aren't they? And, I just hear so many of the Yanks, you know, singing the praises. I'll let you just cradle her and I'll give her a kiss, this one, Waz. I hear so many Yanks singing the praises of the large mouse. I hear so many Yanks singing the praises of the largemouth bass, but I'm sure they don't know about our barramundi. They would actually fall in love with them. And the Americans that come and fish with you just book in time after time, don't they?
They love them, yeah.
Yeah, look at that. You can go back, mate. We won't keep you out too long. Although they're very, very hardy fish, those eyes, similar to the mangrove jack we've just seen, really, they are predators' eyes, aren't they?
They sure are. As long as you support their weight.
Yeah.
Don't hang them up by their lip. They're reasonably hardy.
Yeah.
The sooner you get them back in, the better. So.
He's probably only a couple of years old, that fish. Have a look at it. The system's all right. See you later, mate. All the best to you. Oh, I gave him 9.5 out of 10, Waz. Doesn't look cottage, does it?
That hit very hard. That hit very hard.
Mangrove
very...
jackies, do you think?
I think you could be right.
Oh, wow. That was just sensational.
You saw that when they hit?
I did. And he just, the bait just hit the water and he went bang. Oh, look, mangrove jackies, what have we got in the dirty water here? Give us a look at you, mate. Oh, mangrove jack.
Good guess there, Rex.
Absolutely. Well, an educated guess, because I reckon the more you come up here, the more likely you are to be able to recognise the type of fish. And I tell you what, if this was November, which it's not, we would be taking this guy back with us to have it as beautiful dinner. And I tell you what, Wazza, that is as good as you'll see up here.
Beautiful fish.
Beautiful, beautiful mangrove jack. Barramundi, catfish, cod, brim. They're absolutely cream of the crop up here, and away you go there, mate. Wazza, it's been an absolute pleasure. We sat on deck chairs out in front of the Barra base about, 30 clicks over the top of there by one of your helicopters up here. It's been great to catch you again, and I just think I want to highlight the fact is we could have been casting lures here for 2 days and got absolutely what Jackie shot at. The fact of the matter is, what's going on the day, you just do it, don't you?
You do. That's it. Putting a little bit of bait out's turned a very ordinary day into quite a happy little afternoon session.
Now, folks, I don't want to embarrass Wazza, but I'm going to, because he is my preferred guide when I come to the territory. And if that ain't some sort of recommendation, I don't know what is. And by the time my trusty producer Bob Grief has put this together, Wazza and his beautiful wife Tarn will be happy and proud parents of a brand new bouncing baby. Wazza and Tarn, good on ya. That's what life's all about.